כן יכול לאחת, כך שאולי גם אני אספיק קצת להרשות.
Other views, maybe other kind of the same situation problem. So you have to know to present few solutions, but each solution is a complete package, not half solutions. At Stanford, you have to accomplish two things. So the chief is protected from half-baked ideas, don't bring in half-baked ideas, half-world. Because a full, completed software will be easier to sell to your superior or your manager. If you present half-world, what we call half-baked one, then it's not a thing that is easier to sell. Convinced. Now the final test before you present, and I'll talk about it later about risk assessment and how to do it. Before you present, ask yourself then, if you were the manager, would you accept this idea or not? If not, go and do it again. Don't present things that you or yourself do not believe in. Or not so sure about it. You better go and do it before you present. Now another issue of staff work is reporting and charting. When you are trying to supply data, it is imperative that you do it in a way where the recipient can easily and fully understand and interpret. Your ability to prove your point would mean the difference between creating a solid argument or raising more questions. If you present a graph, or you present, let's say, a plan, usually it comes with some drawings, some plans. Do it in a way that is very clear. Not too much information and not less information. If you compare two plans, compare it in the same method, in the same graphics. Don't compare apples with oranges and say this is like this and this is like this, and you cannot compare them between the two of them. If you make a plan, plan A, plan B, try to use the same wording, the same graphs, even the same colors. So it will be easier to distinguish and to decide between the plans. Now, sometimes information that you present, or when you report something, or you mark something, or you call it sharp something, usually mistakes can happen. Now, there are typically mistakes that are being created when you do use different plans or different ideas or different and result of your staff work. Now we can divide it between one is that you don't check the accuracy of your reports. Sometimes, let's say you want to present figures, but when the manager sees it, okay, here in this plan, you get 100% result, and on this plan, you get 120% result. How come? So you have to check the end result that you get the same result. Another one is putting too much information, as I said before. Too much information, cluttering the decision making, cluttering your staff work, cluttering the results. What the other hand, not enough information doesn't give the entire picture. So again, good staff work is a mixture between too much information and too little information. You have to be very, very clear. Now, talking about it, on this, more about risk assessment or situation assessment. Sometimes you put too much detail. Because you put too much detail on your situation assessment, you get everybody mixed. Now again, I talked yesterday and just before about oranges and apples. Okay? If you have situation assessment result in two different result or end products, because situation assessment, it's your assessment, staff work. And you can present it on one side and then on another side. Try to make it something that you can compare and decide between the two. You can never decide if you present two things in different format, in different terms, in different, even colors. Especially if you present it on graphs. Once it's not the same, very hard to make a decision, and then the manager says, what is this? I don't understand. This is, okay, you are talking about same situation, but like two different situations, not the same. Now, I talked about situation assessment. Now, what is situation assessment? It's a well-planned essential of current data situation. It's a prerequisite for understanding the incident and its development. Now, first of all, if you want to have a situation assessment, which is actually the first thing about emergency management is understanding the situation. You cannot do a situation assessment if you don't understand the situation. So you first of all have to put it in a form that everybody understands. And believe you me, it's difficult to understand the report from the ground that comes, sometimes it looks like two or three different incidents. At the end of the day, they are talking about the same incident, but one is looking at it from that side, the other one is looking at it from that side. Everybody is recording from his point of view. At the end of the day, you are sitting in the center and trying to figure out whether we are talking about the same thing or maybe other. Now, if it's one fire, okay, we are talking about the same fire. But if it's, like for instance, last week we had fires in Jerusalem. At the same time, we had fire in a city close to Jews. Now, once you get reports of this, at the end of the day, thinking, is there two different incidents or are we talking about the same fire? Very difficult. Very difficult. And then, when the radio reported that the traffic jam and traffic has to be diverted from here and there, you get confused. But if you were to go to Jerusalem, the roads are closed, but they are closed because the city before was actually also on fire, but is it Jerusalem or not Jerusalem? The same time. Sometimes we have that case, it was not, but a lot of time we have fires that being intentionally started by terrorism as an act of terrorism. Sometimes they start with this and that. Whether it's the same fire or whether it's the same source, it's difficult, very, very, very difficult to understand. So if you want to make a situation assessment, you have to really, first of all, build up the situation picture from the reports that are coming from any member. So the main objective of situation assessment is to identify causes and causes of action. Sometimes it's one cause of action, sometimes a few causes of action. But the result of situation assessment that comes out of understanding the situation picture is to decide which course of action to take. Send the responder here, send them there. This incident is more important. Maybe we need to send people here. We don't have enough resources. How to use your resources? This is a result of a situation assessment. And we must be very, very clear about the situation, which is all, as I said before, staff. Because the managers do not deal with details. You have to bring them the complete picture, complete summary, for them to understand and make decisions. Which course of action to take. Usually it's good when you come with recommendations. After you did your own staff work, decide which resources you have, whether to use it here and there, why to use it here and not there, all this is staff work. Then they have to make a decision. Because the decision is theirs. Now, situation assessment influences planning in a significant way. Because once you do the assessment, you decide of the course of action, then you have to go and do the planning. I mean, what to do is nice, it's a decision. It's a course of action. But how to do it, that's planning. Usually what we do, at the center, we do situation assessment. We are building the situation, and we have the situation picture. Then we have a meeting, we'll discuss about meeting in a minute. Then we have a meeting. The meeting is called a meeting for situation assessment. So you present the situation, okay, all the incident, whatever. Then you discuss about the situation. Planning is being done outside. You take planning groups, and they are sitting outside, each one have a own resources allocated to him because the process of action was chosen out of limited resources, and they go outside to different rooms as groups and do planning. So this planning is very much influenced by the situation assessment and the decision about what course to take, course of action to take. So if you look largely at the end result of situation assessment, or the steps of situation assessment, is step one, assessment of the information, its sources and quality. Again, when you present, again, I'm coming to staff work. When you present a complete staff work, which is called a situation picture, out of it comes situation assessment. One thing about assessment is looking at the picture, at the information, and whether the sources are trusted, are good, or are not good. So this is the first thing in the situation assessment. Then you do stakeholders analysis. Impact, remember? On one hand, what are the resources? On the other hand, what are the impact of your assessment? How does this course of action? Now, into the assessment or course of action to select, you have to take other things into consideration. It's not only the impact and the analysis and the resources, you have to think about the environmental analysis. And in our case, the Texas, environmental analysis is very crucial. That's why we have these little stations. Meteorological data is important, the geographical data is important. Time of day or night, rain or no rain, everything has to take into consideration because it will affect your course of action, it will affect the planning. Now, what are the end user requests? So you have to analyze the end user requirement. Usually, when you have a situation, you have assessment. At the end of the day, somebody wanted something to be done. And that's what we call the end user. Because your course of action will affect people, end user. Will affect the impacted stakeholders, and it will affect your forces, your responders, and your resources. So you have to also analyze this on the other side. And, as I said, availability of this resort. They are always limited. They always are limited. Not every time you have all the resources. Here maybe you need the neighbors to help. We had a fire last week, 2 years ago, that the Americans sent a big fighting plane, a huge one. Because whoever, all the countries in the Mediterranean sent their planes to extinguish the fire, it was not enough. It kept on going. So we are limited in resources, you are limited in resources, but you always, in emergency, you will find that your neighbors assist and very useful. So availability of resources analysis is very crucial in any emergency. So we are talking about now, we come to staff meeting, another part of staff work. Now there are two types of meetings. One is scheduled meetings. Usually in emergency, I mean I'm not talking about emergency that starts and is over in a few hours. But usually emergencies can last a few days. So once the emergency center is being operated and the emergency responders are being deployed, you are getting into an emergency situation type of working. So you need to maintain a certain program, schedule. Meetings are part of the program and schedule. Meeting usually takes twice a day. Twice a day. You cannot do a scheduled meeting every 2 or 3 hours. So usually concentrate on twice a day. Usually it's early morning and early evening. It could be 8 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock in the evening. But usually it's like that. Why? Because all the entities, all the managers, all the operators in the center or in other centers or regions knows that at that time there is a staff meeting. Now from the upper echelon staff meeting, let's say the government is meeting twice a day. Okay? From this, it's like, okay, the government needs to have the information. Who is supplying them with the information? The emergency management center. So they have to have their information 2 hours, let's say before, 3 hours before. They need to get information from the region, from the ground, from other entities. So they go back an hour before to finish their work and send it to the upper level. So if you have scheduled all the system around the country, the different levels knows the time frame of their work, the time rule. Along this, they need to collect information, assess the situation, provide the assessment to the upper level, and then provide it to the other level until it goes all the way to the top. A scheduled meeting, usually twice a day. Day, I'm talking about 24 hours, day and night. The other type of meetings is what we call ad hoc meetings. Something happens, you want this and these people to attend a meeting about something that just happened or information that just arrived. Don't wait until the next scheduled meeting. Maybe this is very important, very urgent. So you call up an ad hoc meeting. Now, scheduled meeting, the attendant, the participant in this scheduled meeting are defined before. There are predefined lists. Everybody knows who, when you have to attend this meeting, and it comes automatically. Ad hoc meeting, something that just been called, The one who called this meeting has to define who we want to see in this meeting. Not that hard. Only the people who have the information, who can provide the answer, who can do the planning, and so on. Usually it's a small group. Every time it could be a different group. It could be in parallel in many places. But it's an ad hoc meeting that you can do anytime in the 24 hours. Okay, there are two types of meetings. Not so much. Any questions? So we cover the meeting, situation assessment, the operational situation. Okay? Any question? I don't want to explain how to do each step and what to do in each step.
Good comment. Can you go back a couple of slides? Situation assessment, back.
This one?
Yeah, this one. I would suggest you change the spelling of stakeholders. They make it a different
way. I was happy.
You forget it.
Well,
that's the food
good.
You get after you live about it.
Yeah, I made it before dinner. I'm talking about the stakes.
But my statement was EA.
Well done, well done, well done.
Okay.
Okay,
thank you, thank you.
Thank you. After we.